Jacob Olie was a 19th century Amsterdam amateur photographer who started photography in the 1860s, very early, for Dutch Verhoudingen. And he made his photographs for his own sake as an amateur, just to try out the new medium, the new art of photography.
Now you've displayed the exhibition in a certain manner. It looks like we have his early photographs, but then he gave it up for a while, didn't he? What was his other than amateur life like?
He was he was raised as an architect, and he worked for the important architect Lelyman, and also from 1861 on as a drawing teacher at the first technical school in Holland. A few years later, in 1867, he became director of that school, and by then he also had stopped his photographic activities for a very long time, for nearly a quarter of a century. And he restarted photography after his pensioneering in 1890. And he started then anew with new materials, which were then for sale at the photographic shops in the city. He didn't have to make his own negatives and his own printing papers as in the old days. So he was more free to go around and photograph what was of interest for him.
Now you spoke about him making his own photographs. He was somewhat limited by all the apparatus he took with him. Could you tell us a little about his early methods and how he took these photographs in the 1860s?
Yeah. Well, he worked with the wet collodion process. This is for modern people a very complicated process. He had to make his own glass plates and put a collodion emulsion on it, then make it light sensitive, and it had to be done on the spot itself where he wanted to make a picture. So he, after he made it light sensitive, he put it in the camera and made the exposure during a few seconds, and immediately after the exposure he had to develop the plate. And so this meant he had to carry with him his whole laboratory, all his chemistry and everything. He also had to make his own printing papers. He used albumen, this is chicken egg white, or salted paper prints. And both of these techniques can be seen at the exhibition.
He very cleverly put exhibition photographs around Amsterdam, and this seems to really get people's interest, because I've been here and there's a lot of people mm-hmm. showing up for the show. What were Jacob Olie's primary subjects?
As an architect, he was deeply involved in the development of the city at the turn of the century, at the turn of the 19th to the 20th century, when Amsterdam was changing rapidly. And unlike Breitner, who also was interested in the old, more romantic sides of the city, Olie was interested in the modernization, and he approved the way Amsterdam was turned into a modern city, with wide, large boulevards, great buildings like the Rijksmuseum and the Central Station, and all the new churches and the large post office at the Nieuwe Zijds Voorburgwal. So you can see in his pictures that he liked the modern new way in which Amsterdam was changing by then.
Was he a photographer that took a lot of portraits of people or groups of people, or what was his, other than the architectural elements in his photography, which of course are very historical, did he take other personal interest kind of things?
Yes, indeed. He, I think he was a very sociable man. He was he had been a teacher for a long, long time, and his pupils liked him a lot. He was very interested in people, and you can see it in his pictures. He also, in his city views, there are always people around who are posing for his camera. Children, laborers, anybody who lived here in Amsterdam. He was also very interested in special events. He liked it to be present when an air balloon was floating or a large ship was te water gelaten, etc. All the events where a lot of people were present, and he was there with his camera and took beautiful pictures.
Now, when I attended the exhibition, there were a lot of people. Mm-hmm. What are the times, and when is the Gemeente Archive open for the general public?
We're open every day of the week from 11 to 5 in the afternoon.
Now, in your exhibition, you've included a number of things other than just photographs. Would you tell us a little about that?
Yes, we also have made room for his other interests, especially his architectural drawings and designs. And his he also made beautiful water drawings, watercolors of cities around the country, and we have exposed a few of them because you can see he was a good drawer. Yes, he had a good eye, not only to make photographs but also to make watercolors.
Hanneke, it's a delightful exhibition. Lots of people in Amsterdam seem to be very interested in it. So, success with it, and thank you very much for being with us today.
You're welcome. ¶¶